Neeraj Bansal from Fluke Technologies, handling Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh area for Fluke IG business, that is industrial group business. And thanks for Sridharan sir for arranging in-house seminar in such a short notice, and that too calling persons from every department which our Fluke portfolio contains. So starting with Fluke, what is Fluke? I have a very short span of time of almost 10 to 15 minutes, so I will try to cover everything in our portfolio, including what is Fluke in this time. So Fluke is a US-based MNC, founded in 1948 and covering now across the globe for various product range. And these are some of our world's leading suppliers. Like there are different verticals of the Fluke. So right now we'll discuss only just Fluke Industrial Group. Otherwise we have many verticals in Fluke. And now when a product Fluke, any multimeter or any higher end instrument, when it comes to your hand, it goes through a level of testing certificates. These are the certificates which it goes through: drop, battery current, improper EM, impact, overage, impulse, corrosion. Then after all these tests, it come to your hand. It's not like that just manufactured, tested, and one or two calibration certificates and it goes directly to the market. Before that, it goes has to through this process. Now why a Fluke is Fluke? Means everybody, if they know Fluke, then there is some reason because it's Fluke. So these are our USPs: portability, ruggedness, accuracy, safety, ease of use, rigid standards of quality. And these are maintained in each and every model, from lower end to higher end, from the model which got obsolete to the models which got initially got invented. Now this product portfolio. Now as all persons are from all departments, so we have a big portfolio in Fluke, covering from electrical to instrumentation to mechanical to somehow if you have different department for utility maintenance. So we have big portfolio for all these products. Now applications. So where does this Fluke products falls in your application, in your plant? So these are the applications like industrial machinery, electronics, electrical, process. I believe all these departments you also have in your plant. So Fluke falls in each and every application in for every department. Now where do our customers work? So if you see this chart from generation to distribution, each and every place Fluke sits its part, whether it's on small level or a big level, but Fluke existence is there. Now starting with our basic tool inventor of the Fluke company, that is a digital multimeter. So we have big range for multimeters. Like here you can see all the multimeters in yellow color, and then the last one is in intrinsically safe. So wherever you see any product of Fluke in red, that is intrinsically safe. Rest complete IG 100 product range is in yellow color. Now multimeters covers a wide range from technician level to highly expert level multimeters, which can record data for long time, and you can transfer data and export it into graphs, all those things. Then clamp meters we have. Then clamp meters again we have wide range from basic technician to higher level. Some good things of Fluke is that Fluke continuously innovates itself. Like we used to believe in VOC, and based on the VOC from across the world, they reinvent their products itself, which we see in the later part that how they have from the 1948 to 2018 that they have reinvented the same product or redesigned the same products as per the customer VOC only. So this is the first example. Our world's first invention of measuring voltage without any contact. So this is T6 model, and it can measure current and voltage in a same screen without contact. So this is the big invention. We called it on the as a field sense technology. Field sense like is a combination of electrical plus magnetic. So that's why we call it field sense. You can measure the voltage without having any contact with the terminals. Now these are like each and every product range, like which I talked earlier also, multimeter, clamp meter, and these TCs. It consists of various models with various different specification, and that different specifications are designed for different applications. So like all you are from three are from electrical department, so all you three have different applications. So for you three, there are three different multimeters might be there in Fluke for your applications. So similarly for the T6, we have various models according to your range or your requirement. Now, power quality. So power quality is the basic need of any plant. Now we can call it for a forcible, means on the forced basis or unforced basis, but it is a need for a plant to maintain the power quality. Because earlier what happens in old times, there are much of the linear loads were there. Means whatever the loads which were using in the plant, more was sort of the linear loads which generates negligible harmonics. But nowadays loads definition is getting changed. Means plant is using number of loads, non-linear loads like computer, motor control, halogen lighting, and etc., which generate harmonics on exponential level. So before controlling that harmonics, first we need to measure that harmonics, that how much harmonics that are getting generated, because it affect on your that highly costing equipment's age. If more harmonics is there, then age of that instruments will get drastically reduced. So for that thing, power quality comes in picture. That is the major part of power quality. Otherwise, there are many other features which we can use for power quality, like power, voltage, current, frequency. But I guess these are getting monitored or from the your automatic panels or whatever system you are using. But some things are like their energy loss calculator, so you can actually measure what is the your what is the electricity board is charging you on the per unit basis. That you can enter on the basis of that, you can measure what is the losses in INR you are getting in your plant, which is the actual ROI for this instrument or any power quality instrument. So these are the some symptoms like overheating, contact damage, insulation damage for lighting. So every application has its own different symptoms. So on the basis of that application and on that symptoms, we can deduce something like what may be the problem. And with the help of power analyzer, we can see, now you can see some accident pictures are also here. So because of the overlooking, this thing happens in the plant. So these are the typical voltage power problems, like voltage dip sap, overcurrent, energy consumption, then voltage swell, transients, voltage imbalance, flicker, noise. Now what you can do with the power analyzer? So with the power analyzer, you can record data for a long interval, which can give you the knowledge of transient, if any transient is coming in your system, for how much time, because transient is there, has come, but how much value and for how much time, that is more important. So with the help of this long-term recording, you can find out those findings which you never know about that system which you are using from years. Now what are the products which do all these things? So we have, these are higher-end products of the power analyzer 434-435. Anyway, we have big portfolio for again power analyzer, starting from entry-level power analyzer to higher end power analyzer, which can again upgrade it to motor analyzer. So these are some our higher end power analyzers, which we call it 4348, 435, which varies from class S to class A accuracy. And these are some features which I am not going through. Then again, one of the USP of the Fluke power analyzer is that we have thin flex. Those who are in the electrical department, they know that what is the pain point to go to that in the small panel, and you have to plug in that coil. So if that coil diameter is small or thick wires are there, then it is definitely pain, your pain will increase. So on working on that VOC only of customer, Fluke has designed these robustic coils, which can take current till up to 6000 amperes. Then these are some screenshots of the instrument, that how, what are the functions, major functions in any instrument our 434 and 435 covers. So 434, 435 differs in the these four parameters only: flicker, transient power, and main signaling. And these are some screenshots of the instrument that at the time of measurement, running measurement, you can see the same measurement in table format, in graphical format, in harmonics format. So you can switch to any of the window at the time of running condition only. Then event, it can capture events as if your application needs that, what, like we don't want full range to be measured or to be recorded in the instrument. So we can create events as per our requirement, as per our applications. Then these are basic level power analyzers, which covers again the recording, but on a lower side, accuracy and class and all these things. But these are again we have worked on the customer pain points of like RoboSkip coil putting in the terminal, and then after that checking that whether it is as per the current direction or not. So for that, Fluke has again worked on that and designed a digital circuit correction. So now you don't have to again enter in the panel and open that RoboSkip coil. You can digitally correct that circuit. So these are entry level power analyzers. Now Fluke instruments are coming with even our multimeters and clamp meters, leakage current testers. These are also from lower end to higher end. These are coming with Wi-Fi connectivity, wireless connectivity, which is now need of the time because of this IoT. Everything is getting wireless. Everything want to, every instrument, every gadget want to talk to themselves. So for that, Fluke is also moving in that direction, introducing their own cloud, from which you can transmit your data to that cloud, and both instruments can communicate with each other. So we have our proprietary technology called Fluke Connect. With the help of that Fluke Connect, instruments can talk with you with your mobile, and instrument can talk with each other also. So now power analyzer, who needs it? So majorly all the electrical department, whether they are already using it or doing from the third party, or they need it. These are the three situations. These are the model lines differ from some parameters to parameters as per your applications. These are some higher end power recorders which requires to power to be locked on the long interval with high accuracy. So such type of applications we require these type of power analyzers. Then next product is insulation testers. Again, in insulation tester we covered a wide range from 1 kV to 10 kV. So